Good morning everyone, my name is Sonali Panda. I am pursuing B.Tech in National Institute of Science and Technology, Barampur, and this is my B.Tech project. The name of my project is Automatic Music Piano. As the name suggests, it can play music automatically based on the notation, that is music notations which is provided to it. So the question is, how it is going to play the notations? The thing you need to do is, you need to store notation of any music in a file. Then you need to write a Java program which is going to read the notations from the file, and accordingly it is going to play the music. It can play any song of your choice provided you are able to know the notations of the song. Now, the another interesting part of the project is, suppose you are singing a song and you don't have anyone to play the music. Now, the task of that thing can be done by this automatic piano. What you are going to do is, you need to have an Android phone. As you can see, this is my Android phone. And I have developed an app. This is my app. So what this app is going to do is, it is going to find out the notations of a speech. Suppose you are speaking anything, you can speak anything. Hello, how are you, or Saregamama, anything. It is going to find out the notation, that whether it is ASAP, ESAP, music contains some notation. It is going to give us the notation, and that notation will be given to the Raspberry Pi, which is our controller. The main controller over here is Raspberry Pi. It will be given to the Raspberry Pi by means of Wi-Fi. Now the question is, how are you connecting Raspberry Pi and Android phone? As you can see over here, I am going to show you how you are connecting. Go to settings, go to Wi-Fi. As you can see, this is Raspberry Pi AP, it is written. This is the Wi-Fi name of our Wi-Fi access point. We are connecting to Raspberry Pi through by means of Wi-Fi. Once it is connected by means of Wi-Fi, so now let us know what is the technology behind my project. The kind of embedded controller I am using over here is Raspberry Pi. It is a low cost computer. We could have used Arduino, but we are not using Arduino because the time you will require more time to write to program it using Arduino. Since it is a mini computer, you can directly write Java program into it. You can load database directly into it, which is not possible in any other microcontroller. It is a very user friendly embedded controller. It is low cost, it consumes less power, it has high processing capability. You can make it as a data server, you can also load the database into it, and many things can be done. Also, you can directly access Wi-Fi through it by attaching a Wi-Fi dongle, which is not available in any other microcontroller. Suppose you are taking Arduino, you need to have an Ethernet seed, you need to have a Wi-Fi shield, and so on, but this doesn't require anything. The controller, the main aim of our controller was to control the musical keyboard, and it is going to play according to the notation which is providing to it. This is my musical piano. The inside the musical piano, there are having 12 points. For example, you are having from A to L, and each combination, suppose AB is key 1, AC is key 2, and so on. Because each key is a combination of one of the 12 combinations. We need to find out the combination first. After finding out the combination, we are going to attach the keys. Each key is having two pair of wires. These two pair of wires are connected to the normally open point and common point of relays. The relays are controlling the musical keys. Once the relay is switching on, the normally open point gets connected to the common point, and because of which the two pairs of wires of the musical key, they get shorted, and a sound is produced. The controlling part of the relay is the relay driver. The input to the relay driver is coming out from the output of a latch circuit which is present at the down. The question is, why are you using latch circuit? Latches are used in order to retain the previous output. Suppose you want to play a music for a continuous period of time. So, as you know that the property of latch is, until and unless a clock is given to it, it is going to retain the previous output. The same concept of electronics we are using over here. First of all, for the GPI expansion, we are using a decoder circuit, 5x32 decoder, which is made by using 2 74LS74 4x16 decoder. The output of the decoder is given as a clock input to the latch circuit. The latch we are using here is D latch. Once the output of the decoder is given to the latch circuit, then the output of the latch is given as input to the relay driver circuit. Once the input to the relay driver gets high, a relay gets switched on and a sound is produced. The clock input, the input to the decoder, the address pin of the decoder, where each notation is having a particular address. Suppose ASAP, it is having address 0000. BSAP, it is having address 0001, and so on. Each key is having a particular address which is being generated by the Raspberry Pi. The main aim of the Raspberry Pi was to read the notation from the file, generate a decoder address. The decoder address is going to drive the drivers, which is going to drive the relays, and the relays will be controlling the musical piano. This is all about the technology part. Now the Android part. In Android, a program is written which is going to detect the pitch of the voice, for which you are using FFT. You don't need to worry for performing FFT, since in Android you are using an audio processing library which is purely written in Java, known as Tapsource DSP. It is having functions which can find out the pitch of the voice directly. Once the pitch of the voice has been detected, it is going to be converted into notation depending upon the frequency, because our voice has having a frequency. Each notation is also having a frequency. We need to find out the pitch and then match it with the corresponding notation. Once the notation has been found out, it is going to be sent to Raspberry Pi using Wi-Fi. I have already told it before. Now how it can be directly sent to Wi-Fi? You need a container in order to hold the data which is being sent by the Android phone. The container which I am using here is PHP web page. We have developed on PHP web page, which acts as a middleware between the Android app and Raspberry Pi. Once the data or the notation which is sent from the Android phone, it is being stored in the PHP server. Now the PHP server sends one by one into the database of the Raspberry Pi. Then you are writing a Java program which is going to read the notation from the database of Raspberry Pi, and then it is going to generate a decoder address which is going to drive the relays, then the musical piano. Now I am going to demonstrate how it is going to play the songs automatically. I have shown the notation of Saregamapa, Twinkle Twinkle Little Star and Happy Birthday to You in a file. Now I am going to play them. This one is for Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Now, I will play another song which is Happy Birthday to You, then Saregamapa. As you can see here, there are choices which is given over here. Press 1 for music 1, press 2 for music 2, 3 for Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, 4 for Saregamapa, and so on. I am pressing 6, enter. Which is Saregamapa. I am pressing 4 for Saregamapa. The thing we need to do is, we need to open the app. Then we need to select the jar file. As you can see, it is written start listening. Once you start, click over here, it will tell start speaking. Then you can speak and notations will be generated. Sa. So in this way, it is going to be improvised soon. Now it is able to detect a notation and play a key accordingly. We will soon improving it that whenever you are going to sing, and according to the pitch of a voice, it is going to recognize the notation and automatically is going to play. Thank you. This is all about my project. Thank you.